Hi, I'm Reed Aronow, and I'm here in Copenhagen at the COP15 conference with Expedition Copenhagen, a collaboration between the Will Steger Foundation and Stonyfield Farm. Leading up to being here, a group of 12 youth delegates from across the Midwest, we have been preparing for this conference in a variety of ways, including studying high-level policy and doing education in Minnesota and the United States, and connecting that to Copenhagen, as well as preparing actions and preparing activities and events back home in the lead up to Copenhagen to talk about it. Now, while we've been in Copenhagen, we've been focusing on these same things that we have been centered on during the fall. For example, we've been in groups studying high-level policy and meeting with decision makers at the conference. And we have been, I've personally been involved in education and doing video conferences with students back home in Minnesota and back in Washington, D.C. We had one event where we worked with NOAA and the EPA and connected with students back in D.C.
Hi, my name is Charlie, and we have been here already for 2 weeks in the negotiations. As of the past few days, we haven't been able to go into the Bella Center. We have been gathering either in our apartments or at this facility where the NGOs are gathering right now. During the past 2 weeks, we've been working with politicians and negotiators very closely in order to convey the message of the youth. We've also been creating actions in order to bring a message of youth and justice and binding climate treaty into the negotiations. And I've been particularly focusing on the Tech Transfer Committee for policy. And I've been working with an extremely amazing group of young adults from around the world that are representing ideals that we brought together to our negotiators to fight for. It is very interesting how the youth can combine and get together and come up to a consensus on what we want to see in these documentations, and yet our leaders don't seem to do so. For the past 2 weeks, it's been a very intense and labor-intensive time, and hopefully something semi binding will come out of this. I am still slightly hopeful, although the deliberations are being said right now.
What's happening right now? What have you seen today?
Sadness.
Why?
President Obama gave a speech in saying that unless other countries committed to something binding, the U.S. was not going to commit. We've seen the Latin American negotiators discuss how it is not fair that things are not moving forward and that we're not achieving a true binding commitment. The negotiations have gone from 450 parts per million of carbon in the atmosphere to what the NGOs and the youth and some environmentalists were advocating for, which is 350 parts per million, to now be advocating for 550 parts per million, which means that it's a 3 degrees Celsius change in temperature in the following years, which is detrimental to the ecosystems around the world. So the negotiations, rather than moving forward, have started to move backwards, I believe. And there are still some delegates out there fighting for justice and fighting for equitable solutions. So we'll see where things end up towards the end of the day today.
Great. Can you also talk about maybe what gives you hope with Juan Carlos speaking today and introduce who he is?
Okay. Juan Carlos is a youth delegate from Peru. He has been working with a group called Sustainas, and this year he has led a delegation of Latin American youth from across several countries, and they have been working very closely with their negotiators. Since there are very few of them, they have actually been sitting in their meetings and discussing the text and trying to bring a message. And today Juan Carlos was chosen as the youth leader, the International Youth Climate Movement leader, to be delivering a message of the youth stance on these negotiations, and it is going to be a very powerful speech, and hopefully we'll can capture it and show it to you later on.
And what has that been the Will Steger Foundation's connection with Juan Carlos and the Latin American delegation?
Juan Carlos, aside from being a good friend from Sustainas, where we did our training this past August, we have also worked with him in order to fundraise money, in order to bring the youth from Latin America and Global South into these negotiations. And it has been a fantastic experience to know that we collaborate into these youth being part of these negotiations, particularly since they've been so successful in their commitment and they have been so powerful in their messaging. So we feel that it is part of our work that's also enabled part of their work, and it's just really empowering to see how the youth can combine and get together from across the world and breaking all barriers of country, nationality, gender, and just combine and bring a youth message of unity and equitability.
How do you foresee working, continuing these relationships with international partnerships we've had here?
Personally, I am Puerto Rican, so I am a Latin American, sort of, because I'm a U.S. territory.
Mm-hmm.
But I've been adopted by them, and I think that we're developing really good friendship relationships that will enable us to continue working on a professional level further down the road. And I hope that we can continue being connected for years to come and bring an even stronger message, not as North America or Latin America, but as the Americas United, and just move forward from there and try and move in the direction of creating something just that is more of a global movement by working locally.
Great. Thank you.
Hi everybody, this is Jamie again on our last day together on the Stonyfield live stream. Thank you so much for joining us, whether just for today or for all of our presentations over the last 2 weeks. It's been an amazing journey, and let me tell you, we're exhausted, but we're still hopeful, and we're still pushing through, and we're still here watching the negotiations and watching the presentations from all the heads of state today. There are a few things we plan to go forward with as we go back home. One of which is something that Charlie just spoke on, is continuing these international relationships to strengthen our movement back home and to bring a global voice to our local missions. We're also going to be talking and reaching back with the youth that we've been working with throughout the fall, like Reed mentioned earlier. We went and did many presentations all across our states, all across the Midwest, and met amazing groups of youth, many of which are also here in Copenhagen, who have shared this experience with us. So we're going to be working with them to bring back the stories of Copenhagen, what we've seen here over the last 2 weeks, the people we've talked with, the presentations we've seen, and to really use that information and the momentum that we've gained here to mobilize our states, to mobilize our youth to be engaged in an issue that is truly, truly for their future. This is our world that's at stake. This is our world that they're negotiating right now that we haven't been allowed to speak on. So it is up to us to mobilize our youth and to create a national movement that will speak to our government, to mobilize the Senate to take action back in the U.S., and not just youth will be in this movement. The youth will be leading it, but we need all of our communities behind us to create sustainable, localized energy independence, and it is up to us to take that action. So I hope that each of you will not end your partnerships with us just via this internet stream. I hope that you'll continue to track the Will Steger Foundation and the amazing work that they're doing with youth and with education and outreach, and hopefully you'll see some of our faces continued on your news or maybe on a live stream in the future. So enjoy your Stonyfield yogurt. I look forward to going back to the U.S. to my nice bowl of granola-filled Stonyfield yogurt, and thanks again for joining us, and thank you to Stonyfield Farm for giving us this opportunity to bring this message to you.
For the reduction of emissions.